Kevin Down's career of producing, directing, acting, and writing spans more than 30 years. As an actor, some of Down's fan favorite roles include Officer Shane Fuller in Courageous, the video game lover Kevin in Mom's Night Out, a series regular role on the TV sitcom Hitting the Brakes, and supporting roles in I Can Only Imagine and American Underdog. Early in his career, Downs produced critically acclaimed Like Dandelion Dust from best-selling author Karen Kingsbury, which starred Academy Award winner Mira Sorvino and won more than a dozen audience awards for Best Picture at the prestigious film festivals around the world. Co-founder of Kingdom Story Company, the studio is in an exclusive partnership with Lionsgate, aiming to develop life-changing content from a variety of talented storytellers. Their features have all opened in the top 10 box office, and they have received the coveted A+ CinemaScore 3 times. Their latest film, Ordinary Angels, hits theaters February 2024, followed by Unsung Hero in theaters April 26, 2024.
My name is Sharon. I'm just a ticked off hairdresser with a splitting headache.
I'm good at plenty of things. Taking no for an answer ain't one of them.
You just wandered into a lady you never met before's funeral. Why exactly?
Something about that little girl. She's just 5 and she already needs a liver transplant.
Hi, Sharon, remember me?
Yes, ma'am.
So she's gonna help out a few nights a week.
I met this woman. She's a mess.
Perfect. She'll fit right in.
I'm gonna put together a press kit for Michelle, get corporate donations, that kind of thing.
We don't need to be running around worrying about money and bills right now. I just want to be with my family.
That's about saying yes and then figuring out how. Girls, help your daddy out.
I'm not comfortable with this. I'm her father. I'm supposed to be the one taking care of her.
You're gonna have to get comfortable being uncomfortable, because this ain't about you, it's about your little girl. When your insides
breaking in. Michelle will need to fly to the children's hospital immediately. I've had patients who have missed that window because they couldn't get a flight.
Don't lose your faith over this.
Officials are saying be prepared for what they're calling the worst blizzard in state history.
Is it today? Okay, we'll be there. You want to go on an adventure?
Yeah. Let you go.
The roads haven't been plowed. The airport's closed. Honey, listen, it's too dangerous.
I have to make it. This is our last chance. If we don't take it, Michelle dies.
Someone's got to do something. Someone's got to fight for it.
So one thing I know for sure, that little girl now has the entire city rooting for her.
I want you to know something. You're not just worthy, Sharon. You're a miracle.
Hey friends, you just saw a sneak peek of Ordinary Angels across your Christian television network. We're thrilled to sit down with one of the co-founders of Kingdom Story Company and does a whole lot more, as you heard earlier. It's just an honor to have you here, Kevin Downs, in studio.
Paul, it's good to be here.
Well, you do a lot for the kingdom, obviously, to help people see entertaining movies that make a difference in people's lives. And I remember Jesus Revolution, and I can only imagine some of the other films, obviously Courageous, that you starred in. But what is it like as you see the progression of film speaking to the culture? What are you seeing out there? Because you've been doing this a long time now, but it seems like the production values and the messaging is really, even the mainstream world is taking note of faith-based films.
Yeah, that's the dream. I mean, when I started doing this like 30 years ago, my first film was made for like $20,000 with my good friends and my brother. And like, we didn't know how to make a movie. And but we had the gospel so present in it and at the center of it. And when we got that movie out, it was back when there were no Christian movies in theaters. And there was VHS, if people remember what that was. And we were literally just giving copies away to Christian bookstores because we wanted to see if there was a hunger for the movies that we wanted to make. And when that movie was successful, there was a hunger for it. I'm like, you know what? Wow. What if one day a Hollywood studio would not only pay for, but also distribute the movies that we make that have Christ at the center of it, where most of America, which is God-fearing, they believe in Christ, they want to see content that reflects their values, would want to go out and support. And that was the dream, and wasn't sure if it would actually happen. But then obviously you have a lot of kind of trailblazers like the Kendrick brothers, who obviously I got to know really well on the set of Courageous. And their movies really blazed a kind of a trail for us with myself and John and Andy to do I Can Only Imagine, which a lot of people, you know, obviously went and watched. And that opened up our partnership with Lionsgate. And they're like, look, whatever you guys want to make, we want to be behind you. We want to be your partners. We believe in what stories that you want to tell. And so here we are. We did Jesus Revolution this year. Weren't sure if people wanted to still go back to the movie theater and see this stuff, but they really did. They showed up. And because of that, we now have our next movie in theaters called Ordinary Angels. It comes out February 23rd everywhere across North America. It's a big release, big cast. I mean,
talk about who's in that cast.
I know, who knew that we could get Hilary Swank. She's won a couple of Oscars. She's the sweetest person on the planet. I so loved working with her. You know, she lives not in Hollywood. She lives out in the middle of America on her ranch, and it's just really down to earth. And what you would expect when you see her. I was so pleased just to meet her. And then, of course, Alan Ritchson, who's everywhere right now. He plays a Reacher on the Amazon show Reacher. And what I didn't expect with Alan, number one, he's an on-fire believer, which is not necessarily a secret because he does these YouTube sort of podcasts where he'll give Sunday sermons.
And that's awesome.
But he's very quiet. He's just very unassuming, which is not what you think of when you see him because he's such a big man. But he has such a soft and gentle heart. Like just when you meet him in person, you can't help but to root for him and almost literally fall in love with him. Like you're like, Alan, I want to do anything to help you win because you're so deserving of the success that you now have because it's not, he didn't just all of a sudden stumble into this. Here's a man who was patient throughout his acting career and was wondering, at what point is God going to call on me? And it's happened for him here in the last couple of years. And so we're so blessed to have him in this movie. The fact that he resonated with the story, him and Hillary together were really great. It's a beautiful, beautiful, true story, as most of our movies are. Mm-hmm. That just really showcases, you know, we wanted to make a movie that showcased what ordinary people in an extraordinary situation, extraordinary circumstance, what would happen if a community rallied behind them and did the impossible to lift them up? Could the miracle happen? As God provides us with the tools to be able to live, we still got to be the hands and feet of Jesus to be able to live out the faith that we believe, right? And so this story is a representation of that. And so it meant a lot to us. And in the church it's about, we know very well, that story actually was pitched to us by our partners at Lionsgate. That's the kind of the odd thing about it. But then when we dug into the story, we're like, wait, we know this church, Southeast Christian, Louisville, Kentucky.
Yeah.
Very big church.
Does other films.
Yeah. And yeah, right. And Pastor Dave Stone, who's now retired, but was the pastor at the time that this happened in 1994, was actually a good friend of ours. And it was crazy. It was like, we know this. We got to dig into this. Like, how did this story happen and unfold, and it all checked out, and it was just a beautiful thing how it kind of developed and came together. Like, okay, we got to make this. Now it's gotten to the point where the story is so undeniable that God kind of put it in our lap, and I think we need to make this movie.
That's pretty awesome. What do you look for, Kevin, when you go about trying to determine a movie that reaches people from all walks of life? I mean, because that's one of your facets, I'm assuming.
Yeah, no, I mean, it's one of those things where, you know, we pray that, look, God, this is what we are looking for. And he knows the desires of our heart because we've been very consistent about it. And so when that story comes along, it's almost like, oh, we know it. He puts this thing in our heart. It's like, okay, yeah, you got to tell this. Sometimes it's quick and sometimes it's not quick because we're not that smart and we got to wake up to the truth. And this was one of those stories. We weren't quite sure at the beginning, but then when it just kept presenting itself and the things were undeniable, we believed, okay, you know what, God's at the center of this. And especially after hearing Dave's heart, Dave is such an awesome man of God. And it's like, when you hear him talk, you're like, wow, okay, I got to be like that. And I want to tell that. And I want people to see that.
That's awesome. What can the church do in the body of Christ in general to, I like to say that your films transcend all ethnic and religious boundaries. And I like the fact that films are used in such a powerful way, as you've been doing for over 30 years, to reach people who may never hear or they've heard the name Jesus, but have had a relationship with Jesus Christ. But how can the church utilize this film to reach somebody in their sphere of influence in their community?
Yeah, I mean, this is a great example of a movie where, you know, there's so many people that are going to relate to the main characters of this story, whether it's the roles, the characters that Hillary or Alan plays, or even the children. It'd be like, you know, both the children, or in our story, the younger child is struck with a terminal liver disease, needs a transplant. And so, you know, that as we dug into it, we realized that organ donation and transplants is actually quite common. And there are a lot of people that either if someone in their family's not dealing with it, they know somebody who's dealing with it. And it's actually the reason why Hillary said yes to this, because her father was a lung transplant recipient. And so when we heard that, we're like, you know what, there's a way that we can impact by being an example of the gospel, by impacting our community. And so we have certain programs where we're trying to give back, just like the movie does. When you see it kind of unfold in the story, we're modeling that and want to give back to the community, so we understand the power of when people come together, it actually lifts everybody up.
I love it. And we're going to talk about your next project in just a moment, but why is it so important for support of opening weekend? About how critical that is, because one thing I know is over the years is that that's what determines the longevity of a film in the theaters city.
Yeah, the simplest way to put it is opening weekend. And it's kind of only opening weekend. It's really interesting how it works, but opening weekend is like an election. And so you have a chance that opening weekend, those first 3 days or 4 days, if it opens a little bit early, to cast your vote. What we don't know is no matter what movies we see, if we see them opening weekend, we're casting a vote for those kinds of movies to come out. Case in point, like, that's why there's been 800 Marvel movies, and I'm exaggerating, obviously, but because so many people go to see them. Mm-hmm. And so then Marvel and Disney and whoever is behind them will continue to make those movies because people are supporting them. And so it's the same way with our films. Opening weekend, you cast your vote. I mean, it's whatever the movie ticket is in your area. Obviously, we want you to be entertained. We want you to leverage the film to be able to use it for ministry, whether it's in your church or in your neighborhood, in your small group, no matter what it is. But then also we want you to cast your vote because that's how more films like this continue to get made. Case in point, when Jesus Revolution opened and Lionsgate saw the results of that immediately, Ordinary Angels got a release date on the calendar. And I mean, literally, it just happened really fast. And then since then, this is exciting, and we've announced this, we have 5 theatrical release movies, including this one. So this one plus 4 more that are coming out in the next 12 months. I don't know if that's ever happened in my career, where you have 5 major releases. I mean, studios on average release like 16 movies a year, and we have five, all from Lionsgate. And so that's it's almost humbling in a way, because I look at it and I'm like, okay, God, you have exceeded what my expectation is in this. I did not anticipate this. And so we give you the credit for sure. And whatever happens, we praise you and we give you the credit for it, no matter what happens through it. And so, but it answers the question, why can't more Christ-centered movies that have production values like everything else be in the theater? And that's something I've been asked for 30 years. And so that was the goal the Irwins and I started Kingdom Story Company, was to do that. And right now we're in the heart of it and it's happening and lives are being changed. Jesus Revolution was awesome. We pray for the same result for Ordinary Angels and for the rest of our films this year.
I love it. And I love the fact that you're trying to honor God through the process, and he's doing exceedingly abundantly above all we could ever ask or think, because his power is working through each one of you and your team. So that's awesome. Well, we're going to talk about how they can connect so they can go to that website and get resources. They can get tickets, group buys. Talk about group buys real quick.
Yeah, group buys. If you go to our website, of course, kingdomstorycompany.com, or just Google the movie Ordinary Angels, we can help get a discount in group buys. Obviously, you can go to your local theater if you have a contact there and just tell them, hey, I got whatever it is. It could be 10 people, 20 people, 100 people. And they'll usually work with you to be able to get you a group discount. But we're happy to do as well. We got teams standing by that are happy to make the connection and get you a little bit off that ticket.
That's right. Well, vote your values and show up opening weekend, February 23rd. Can they maybe go a day early, maybe?
You can go a day early. Yeah. The 22nd will be out there Thursday as well. But the show times are listed right now. And so people should just Google it at their local theater and see what time and when it's playing.
Get the tickets. And we're going to come back to you in just a moment. Let's show them a sneak peek of your next film, Unsung Hero. We'll be right back with Kevin Downs on your Christian Television Network.
Let's go.
How y'all doing?
Are y'all from England?
Australia. Australia. Wish I had an accent.
Dad, I wrote a song. Thought maybe we could ask for an audition.
Oh, that's great, honey. Let's take it one step at a time. Okay, he tells me you're a promoter. You know someone looking for one? Well, I may know somebody who should be.
She's been given a beautiful voice. It's a miracle.
She's a special one, son. Your family, they're not in the way. They are the way.
There's no food, and we're almost out of money. We need to make some changes. Kids, we need your help. This is everything we have, and sometimes it's going to grow, and sometimes it will shrink. But it cannot be allowed to disappear. I wonder if he's right. Maybe I'm not meant to sing. Or maybe you're not meant to sing other people's songs. It's going to be dangerous and scary. And giving up, giving in, it's not an option. Whatever your dream is, I know you can achieve it.
Please welcome my big sister.
My dream is to be like you. It always has been.
All right, there's another sneak peek of your next film, Unsung Hero. How did that come about, Kevin?
I love this film. I love this story. I love the people behind this story so much. I can't tell you how excited I am about this film. The Smallbones, Joel and Luke Smallbone, who are for King and Country, love their music. If you don't know their music, find it.
For King and Country.
most of us know their music, or at least one of their songs. And, you know, this is their origin story. It's a story of how they and their family, when they were just little boys, came to America, and the struggles that their mom and their dad went through. And they put God and Jesus at the center of their family, and what happened as a result of their faithfulness and how God rewarded them in their faithfulness. And I think what makes it so extra sweet is I've known the Smallbones, and of course their sister, Rebecca St. James, who was a major recording artist when I was in my 20s, and I was her and I have known each other for about, gosh, almost 25 years. She acted in one of my early films.
Wow.
And so I've known the family a long time, and now to be able to come back around and to be able to help tell their story is just so sweet, because they are the real deal. They are the real thing. And their story is as good as that trailer the movie is. It's very inspiring.
You know, I remember meeting Rebecca St. James in my hometown of Tulsa, Oklahoma, coming from a music background. I remember meeting her somewhere backstage at an event, and I always thought she was authentic, you know, and I can see that even in the family, you know.
Yeah, they fight for the gospel. I mean, that family fights for the gospel, and anytime see that, you want to root for them. You want to go alongside them. When they pitched us their story, I was like, maybe we should slow this down a little bit and understand it. And all of a sudden, it was in production. And like Joel was like a force of nature. And he had a vision for this. And Andy, my partner Andy Irwin, went alongside and helped. And Josh Smallbone was their lead, Josh Walsh was their lead producer. And Josh, of course, has worked with me for the last 10 years. And so we had the team in place to kind of help. And when the movie came out, I was a wreck. I was in such tears. I do have a small cameo in it, courtesy of Joel. not because of that, I was in tears, but I was in tears because they really nailed the story so good. Mm. And in a interesting twist, Joel plays his dad in the movie. And so, which is very brave of him to do that. So he directs the movie, he plays his dad in the movie. Of course, he does some of the music, and it's just a family event. But the film delivers so much. You're gonna laugh, you're gonna cry, you're gonna celebrate the fact that the gospel is being fought for in a way that we just love and wanna get behind.
Awesome, you know, I love it that, you know, it's another true story.
Yeah.
And, you know, you contend for the faith. That's what this show is that you're on. You contend for the faith in your sphere of influence. And they had a dream in their heart. And that old saying, the dream that never leaves you, is the dream that God assigns you to.
Yeah.
And it's amazing how they continue to do that.
Yeah, and at the end of the day, I think what's important to note is that, and you see this in the movie, that no matter what happened, no matter what the final outcome was, they were content at what God was going to do for them and be their ultimate provider. Because at one point, you see in the film, they're stripped of everything. They have nothing, literally have nothing. And it is only through God's people that they are not completely homeless and off the street. It's just a remarkably inspiring story. And it's so, so well done.
Yeah.
So April 26th, we decided to open it like the week before Mother's Day or 2 weeks before Mother's Day. And just allow that, because the movie celebrates moms. And we're like, you know what, that's the perfect time to kind of come out with this. And it's coming. So mark your calendars, April 26th as well.
And how can they connect to the film?
Yeah, Unsung Hero, themovie.com. Go to kingdomstorycompany.com. That's where we have all of our films. Mm-hmm. And you'll see a link for Unsung Hero. The trailer's already out there. You can share it with people. And tickets, if they're not on sale, they'll be on sale soon.
What's the ultimate takeaway you want to see with this particular film?
Yeah, I want people to grow in their faith with this film. I want them to see when things are tough that, you know what, that doesn't mean that God has abandoned you in this moment of crisis. And it's the film is such a great example of that. I've experienced it in my own life where things are tough, whether it's through health or physicalness or career, where you go, God, have you abandoned me in this moment? Why am I struggling so much in this moment? And yet, what we don't realize is God is always there. He hasn't abandoned us. He's always there. He says, I'm right here beside you, but there's a purpose. There's a reason. I don't want you to suffer, but you're in a world that's completely broken. And you might suffer in this moment, but that doesn't mean that you're not saved.
Amen. Yeah, in this world you'll have trouble, but he's overcome. And it takes perseverance.
Yeah.
And I think that's one of the keys that I, in observing the film, had the privilege of early. But again, I want to encourage you and exhort you, friend. Make sure you invite someone that maybe knows about God but has never encountered Jesus as their Lord and Savior. These are great films to do that with. And Kevin, talk about, if you will, some of the other cast, or kind of the behind the scenes of the family, if you will.
In Unsung Hero.
Yes.
So a longtime friend of mine, who again was in another film of mine, Candace Cameron Bure, plays a role in it. She's great. She so wanted to be in the film because she is such a fan of For King and Country and knows the Smallbones well. And she's like, I will do anything to be a part of this. It wasn't really a tough ask whatsoever. Lucas Black, who's a longtime actor and has been in a lot of things, same thing kind of happened where he's like, tell me where to be and how I show up and I'll be there. And so a lot of great sort of cameos. The leads are great and the acting is just top notch, and people are going to be really, really encouraged, inspired, and emotionally moved, especially towards the gospel when they see the film. And that's what we aim for.
I love the fact that you are not shying away from the gospel and making great content, great films that impact lives and bring a sincere life change, man.
And it's tough. We just literally, 2 days ago, I just came from Canada. We wrapped our latest production called The Best Christmas Pageant Ever. Dallas Jenkins, who is the creator of The Chosen, is our director of this one. We have a huge cast in it. The book, of course, is very popular, very well known. Even the play is, but oh my goodness, the whole third act of that movie is about the birth of Jesus, and Jesus is everywhere in that thing.
Love it.
And that'll be out at Christmas. But again, we're like jumping from making movies, because each movie, it takes us like a couple of months to make it, and then another, 4 months or so to do the post-production, and then another 6 months to do the marketing. And when we're doing multiples in a year, they all overlap, and it's just an incredible effort. And so we ask for your prayers. How you can help is also just pray for us that God would continue to give us the strength and the good health to be able to fight the good fight and continue to make these great films that glorify Him and put Him at the center.
That's awesome. Well, go to the website right there on the screen and download the trailers, show them in your church, video announcements, mobilize the body of Christ. That's why we're here today. We want to exhort you that are watching. If you're a pastor, you have resources there. You can even have sermon messages. It's just incredible. Use film to impact your region with the power of the gospel. And that's what's powerful about film. It can reach people. And these are seeds being planted, and then you do the discipleship after that. And it's just refreshing. So thank you for all that you do, Kevin, and Kingdom Story Company and all your team. And thank you, friends, for standing up and being counted and saying, you know what? I want more of this type of values in my city, in my area. And when you support opening weekend, as Kevin said earlier, you are voting for more of this content. So tell your in-laws, heck, tell your outlaws, tell them all, because it will make a difference in somebody's life. Until next week. Same time, same place. We will see you soon across your Christian television network. We love you and God bless you.